All right, my friends, welcome back. This is just a real quick video. Really, what I want you to do is just look at these four graphs. All right, identify the horizontal asymptote, identify the y-intercept for each of these graphs, and then there's three questions that I want you to try to answer regarding what you see here. And this is just try to get you thinking about those mother functions, some of the things that we've talked about already this year. All right, and get them thinking, get them on your mind as we explore graphing. Exponential functions with our lesson today. So go ahead and pause the video, see what you can decipher with all of this, and we'll come back and discuss it together. All right, so what I'm gonna do is this, I'm gonna go to my work here. And so as you look at our graphs here, all right, hopefully you saw that the horizontal line is, or asymptote is y equals 4. And one of the connections is I see the plus 4 up here, right? My horizontal asymptote is negative 10. I see that up here, right? Okay, same thing in our two graphs down here, right? So y equals 1, I can see the 1 up here. Y equals negative 3, I can see that here. Now, the second thing that we wanted you to kind of notice is that what effect, all right, does the a value have on our graph, right? And so when I look, here's y equals 4, my y-intercept is 0, 9, all right, and the difference between 4 and 9 is a 5 right there, right? Okay, y equals negative 10 is my horizontal asymptote. If I go up to my y-intercept, that's 0, 3, it's the same as that a value right there. So that a value, remember when we talked about our relationships with our mother functions, all right, it's a multiplier for our y values in our range for a given function. All right, you see this here, right? So there's 1, my y-intercept is 5, it differs by 4. All right, so that was really some of the big things that we wanted you to pick up on, right? And so if I go back to the summary sheet, right, so we should see that the k value out here, that tells us where that horizontal asymptote is going to be. All right, the distance between the y-intercept and the horizontal asymptote, all right, that's equal to a. We'll talk a little bit more about how that helps us when we're graphing in the full lesson in just a moment. And then this was just kind of a secondary consequence that we were hoping you would pick up on. So when is an exponential function increasing or decreasing? Well, if you look at the graphs where our base of our exponential is greater than 1, they're going uphill or increasing. All right, when we have a base that's less than 1, and notice we say less than 1 and not a fraction, right? Because you could have a base of like 5 halves, all right, and that's not less than 1, so it would still be increasing. So we don't want to say fraction or not a fraction. We want to think about it as greater than 1 or less than 1. All right, so if we have a base less than 1, it's going to be decreasing. And so what our hope is that we just wanted you to kind of go through this exploration, see a few things, and that way then when we do our next lesson, which in just a few moments for me, I don't know when it'll be for you guys, when you watch that video, right, you'll have a few things on your mind. So thanks for tuning in. All right, I'll see you in the next lesson.